Welcome to Hip Hop Raised Us. I'm Aarona Lopez.
Tony Baker.
Mike DeBay is on vacation today. I just want to say that. That's what they said on TV.
On vacation.
Yeah, he getting that work in, so he couldn't make it today. But he will be missed.
Via satellite.
Via satellite. Today, we have one of my favorite people, okay? In comedy. You are. You're like my little sister in the game. She's the exact same age as my real-life little sister.
We're about to be 30.
Yeah, she's born in 87, just like you, boo. We have the lovely Miss Comedian Jonnae Thompson in the house.
Thank you all. Thank you so much. You're far too kind.
Yes. And we will be joined by the good brother, FuQuan Johnson, also a funny comedian. He'll be here shortly. But we're just going to jump into today's episode with our beautiful queen, sun-kissed goddess.
You know, trying to keep up with you, Aarona.
Amen, praise
you. You know, Tony Baker.
Tony, let me ask you something. Yeah. Do you have a nickname that women call you? Like a boo thing? Nobody out here calling you Big Tone or something like that?
I mean, you know, some women have nicknamed the package, but not like me.
What they name it?
I mean, you know.
He took his hat off.
Tell us.
Y'all can't see it. Tell the thing. I mean, you know.
What was this one? It was this one nickname that was fairly recent.
He's
I forgot what she called it, though.
You need to remember that. The one who took the time out to name your friend, she cares about both of y'all.
I can't remember what it was, though. It'll come to me.
Was it like a one word, like a syllable, one syllable name?
I'm just curious, because Tony's like so serious. Like, Tony's a fun guy with like big cheeks and like the warmest
the
smile.
Dimples.
But Tony's serious, though.
I'll be silly, right? You're
comedy silly. I don't know. Like in your regular day to day, you're not over the top. Like, you just chill. You just chill. You be serious.
Because I'm not on stage. I feel like, you know.
I dig that.
You got to be performing in these streets.
Yeah, now you don't have no
What about the sheets?
Oh, yeah. You got to perform in the sheets.
And that's how you get a nickname.
You got to
They call you the entertainer. That's what they call you.
Sheets.
Is that what they
The entertainer.
The entertainer.
My nickname is Peanut.
The entertainer.
Ooh.
The entertainer.
The entertainer? Would that be good, though?
Yeah, you want to tame.
Oh, I'm taming these savage beasts.
Here's what's interesting about Jonnae, you guys. She waited, okay?
She was
on the Jesus plan.
She waited for a long time.
She was on the no sex in the champagne room before marriage plan.
But she folded.
Because we all do. You're supposed to.
Under pressure. Pressure got me.
What, rape?
No, not rape.
Oh, that's what it sounded like. The pressure got me. Like, what
pressure? The pressure of wanting the dick. Like,
okay.
Just wanting it. You know, it's more like, why am I waiting for something I know I want?
And you was how old?
I was 26.
She was 26, yeah.
I waited.
Ladies,
if you're a virgin, don't wait.
Oh.
Yeah, like that's, yeah, I feel, well.
Don't give it away too early. You can't be 12 out here. I think you're tired.
Yeah, let me put a preface. But like, if you know you want to be getting it in, like.
After you 18, just let it go.
Just like, because nothing's really going to change. Like, that's the thing. Like, I really was, like, once I finally did it, I was just like, okay, I'm glad I waited, but I'm also like, it wasn't.
What magic was you expecting to take place? You know what I mean?
I don't even know if I was expecting. And that's partially why I did it. I knew it was no magic. It was just like, just do it. Like, wait for the right person, the right moment. Like, you want that to be someone you. It was amazing.
Okay.
We watched Lev Jones.
Out the gate?
Oh my God!
Oh, he caked with you before he
left. Actually, Lev Jones watched us. Like, that's
okay.
It was great. Sometimes
that's good.
But you know, like, you gotta do it, because one thing that parents don't tell you, at least your mama and them never tell you, the feeling of new sex is amazing. Like the new, like when you get the new and it blow your mind.
Is it though for women?
Yes. Like for women, you know, like we're receivers. Okay. Uh-huh. So you know, we learn everything we're supposed to learn from our partners. Like, usually...
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? The guy is more experienced, usually, in typical situations. They're older, and they, like, put a little something on you, and you're feeling your way through it, literally. And you're like, oh, this is cool. So then, when you have another experience, and it's, like, awesome, it's like, oh, this is what it's supposed to feel like. Then you discover yourself a little bit more. So then when somebody come along and surpass it, you're like, I never knew.
That was the thing about waiting. Like, I definitely learned quick that, like, you got to create your own because I was like trying to do stuff that maybe this guy liked, and like this dude's looking at me like, what is that? Like, don't rub my nipples, that's gay. But it was like, but Dave loved it, you know?
Yeah, no, everybody got to be
out here loving the nipple rubs, huh?
That it's a really sensitive area. Like, you should try it one time. I get it, I mean, it's the areola. Like,
it's all about sensations.
Is male nipple different than...
No, if you blindfold him, I bet you he'll shut the hell up and take it.
You ain't never had it.
I mean, I've had it, but I'm just like, yeah.
It turns you off? Yeah, you can tell the guys it turns off. It didn't
really do that for me.
Everything that don't do something for everybody, but okay, look, now that you're out here, you can't come and slut yourself out. So,
nope. I'm only a slut for one.
That's how it should be.
I think that's how you,
every guy deep down really want that, no matter what they say. They want to look at the thoughts, but they want somebody who's just a freak for them. They don't want the hoes that's for everybody. They want to look at the hoes, they want to pay the hoes, they want to, you know.
I don't want to pay the hoes.
Some people want a cornucopia hoes, though. I do know some swingers. Yeah, like they, you know, it's facts. Some people, they need the variety. That's what they need. That's what it is. Like,
it's Hollywood, so yeah, you see that.
Not even Hollywood.
Everybody need that variety.
It's in Alabama. Yeah. You better believe
Alabama?
That.
Alabama?
I'm just saying everywhere. It's in Missouri?
Yeah.
Nebraska?
Just variety.
Idaho.
By variety.
Why do you think strip clubs so popular?
In Portland.
What do you mean by variety?
Just variety, day, exactly, like, this one is cool, she got the personality, this one make good food and give me the head that I like, this one here,
I see what you mean.
You know,
yeah.
Like, just when you can have it that way, it's like,
yeah, why wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Some people like it. Let's get into some hip-hop.
Hip-hop, I know, we're talking about love.
Let's get into, I like how you made that hip-hop little transition. Right. Yeah, let's talk about Remy Ma. Listen, first of all, Remy has gave me my entire life for the last 48 hours. When I tell you she is my new favorite, fuck everybody. You know what I mean? I already liked female MCs, and I already, like, had my top 10 set, but I'm going to have to make some room. Some niggas going to have to get traded. Somebody going to have to get pushed to the bench, because Remy is coming on my list.
All time?
Man, look, we had this conversation last week, well, 2 weeks ago a little bit, where we kind of touched on it. She's underrated. Now, look, she shot a bitch in the stomach, okay? She did. Uh-huh. She shot a bitch in the stomach, and it got her put away. But when she left at the height of her career. She left with a platinum album. She left with platinum singles. Annie Up. She left with Lean Back. She left with Conceited. She left with all of that and got locked up. And she's only 2 years apart from Nicki Minaj. That's why when people get
really?
Nicki's 34. Remy Ryan's only 36. That's why.
Really?
That's why all these bitches of my son's shit come from. They was close in age.
Okay.
And, you know, back when Nicki was dyking and stuff, she was, like, you know, giving it to Remy. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So it's like, Remy, like, bitch, you know you love me. Stop it.
Right.
Wait. Nicki Minaj be getting with chicks?
Nicki Minaj. You ain't seen that old YouTube video when Nicki Minaj was the stud in the stairwell? Talking about some, I ate the box. What?
Oh.
You 7 years late on that. Like, because... when you see it, you see her, and you're like, yo, that is her. And she ain't have all that buffoonery going on. Right. She didn't have all the certain clothes. The way her pants sat on, like, her little, she was, like, dressed study, so her boxers, the way them treat, like, she ain't had no ass in that.
Hilarious.
You know what I'm saying? So,
I never knew.
Yeah. So, but people, like, they don't give Remy the credit. And when Remy came, she came with so much bars and so much wordplay that in other classic battles, we would be, you know, she getting her props right now. Everybody's like, God damn, Remy, like, washed her, like, yikes. But, I mean, when it was Jay and it was Nas and the way they went back and forth, everybody was like, yo, and Nas said this and that. She came hard like that where it's so quotable you can't deny it. The only thing that would make me happy, that would be, like, historical and put me, like, in rap beef heaven is, like, if Lil' Kim would get in the studio and at midnight drop Black Friday, too. Because ain't no bitch ever been tag teamed in the beef. Oh, like, ain't nobody been jumped.
And she should.
God,
she
how
should.
Would that be?
Nicki played her. Nicki tried to.
She tried, but see, Lil' Kim got it, Nicki, hard. Black Friday went hard. But Lil' Kim let Nicki Minaj troll her and she didn't come back with another song. Mm-hmm. If Nicki kept putting out music, I mean, not Nicki, if Kim kept putting out music like, nah, bitch, fuck you, Kim would be the hero. I mean, because just like I said, with Jay and Nas, they didn't do just one diss track.
Right.
That, Jay said when he said, you know, you don't want an ass nonce, you don't want it with hoe. No. Jay was like, okay. And I was like, okay, you got yourself a gun. Then Jay was like, oh, for real? I got myself a gun. But really, I don't need the heat. Your heart pump Kool-Aid, you know, Project Kool-Aid is sweet. We like, oh, shit. Jay came back. So then Nas was like, all right, I'm gonna let that ride. Then Jay came back again with Super Ugly. And Nas was like, wait a minute. Whoa. And then Nas dropped Ether.
No, Ether was before Super Ugly.
Ether was before Too Ugly, mm-hmm. but still, like, you know what
Too
I'm saying?
Too Ugly was a get back on Ether because
he, you know, it sure was. He sure was because Jay's mama made him get on the radio and apologize.
Yeah.
Damn, that's hip hop.
Yeah. Like, and then Nas slightly touched on it again on The Realest Niggas Alive.
Yes.
On the Gossip House. It was just a quick, like, he was just telling the story.
Yeah.
But it was dope.
But that's what I'm saying. They kept making songs because it was like, no, nigga, I mean this.
Right.
You gonna feel these bars.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, even, like, just all of it. So it's like for Kim to come and get at her and get at her hard, and then like everybody knew it, and Nicki like kind of gracefully like didn't acknowledge it, kept talking about her numbers, ha ha, you sold your album on PayPal, bitch. And she let that get to her, and she didn't come back with nothing else. Kim kept saying she was gonna come back with something, she ain't come back with nothing. Remy is not the one to mess with the whole
thing. She gave her so many warnings. That's the thing.
Yes.
She gave her a lot of warnings.
I'm not talking about you.
She gave her a lot of warnings.
Like, here's the thing, though. The Remy Ma, it's a scathing diss, but it's more of a conversation.
Like, which is dope.
It didn't feel like a song. Like, her flow was mad lazy. She just talking. I was just like listening. Like I was at her crib in the living room. Like, oh, for real? Oh, the ass deflated? That's crazy. So it felt like, you know, it didn't feel like, I won't be bumping it repeatedly. I'll just be listening for the information.
No, I'm going to be repeating.
And Ether, like you listen to those in the regular rotation. It's like, yo, The Bitch in You by Common, No Vaseline. These are like tracks you can listen to. But this is more of a like, oh, she just giving all the scoop.
No. I disagree, Tony. I think, first of all, I've been listening to it.
Yeah.
First of all, when the first time I heard it, I listened to it, heard the whole thing. I was like, bitch, give me that again. Wait a minute.
Yeah.
And then I heard it again. Like, and it went off. It's like, no, don't go off, bitch, again. Like, please, again, give me that.
With the flow and energetic.
This is what I liked about it. This is what I liked about it. So, Nicki came out with Swallow, okay, on Jason Derulo new album, it's a like track or whatever, and she dropped that on her page. Then she also came out with Make Love with Gucci Mane and dropped them on her page. And she dropped them on her page back to back, and she kept posting them and reposting them on her page like, I'm working. One of the lines in one of the songs, because she dissed her on both songs. One of the lines she dissed, I think it was on the Swallow one. She goes, she's been taking shots, but they all been whack. Like talking at Remy, like I gave these bitches 2 years, but now I'm back. She been taking hella shots, but they been all whack. And then she was like, I'm from Queens, where niggas listen to a bunch of Nas. I'm a yes, and you bitches is a bunch of Nas. So Remy heard that and came back on Nas's classic roast. You know what I'm saying? His classic rap battle track, Ether, and roasted and rolled her ass for 6 minutes straight. Oh, you like Nas, bitch? You like Nas, bitch? I got some Nas, bitch. Here's some 6 minutes of me. That shit was pure comedy.
Yeah.
On top of like comedy and the wordplay. Come on, man. Look,
it's a good listen. Woo, I like straight up front dissing. I don't like no subliminal.
Yeah, that's
just
subliminal.
Tell us who you coming at, why, and where. I love it, but just the flow is just too, it's lazy, though.
Man, I'm going to get to that in a second. Real quick, we just got FuQuan Johnson stepping in.
We got food in the building.
Oh, my God, my whole social.
Okay, and embrace him. My bad, Foo. You want your IG handle?
He always do that.
What is we, 25? You want your IG handle?
Nigga, my IG just got me. You know when a nigga mumbling some bullshit, you go,
the trail off.
Basically. Y'all good?
We out.
You're welcome. What y'all talking about?
Right now we talking about the Remy Ma diss.
Yeah.
Well, this is what I said like right before you came in. I liked Remy before. Remy left at the top of her rap career, okay? Sure. She left with a platinum album, platinum singles.
That album went platinum?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Something about Remy and was number two. How dare you? She was number two on the rap charts. Google.
In fact, that was back when albums were going platinum, too.
So yes. I think she got a platinum album.
People buying CDs.
We did this two episodes ago.
We didn't look at the...
She got songs. She got songs.
You was looking at chart placement. That's not platinum.
But look. Come on. You know? East Coast. Come on, Jersey. Come in here, Jersey.
Yo, Remy's a shit. She still is. You know what I'm happy about? This whole thing? Bars, for one.
Come on.
And the fact that I like Nicki. Nicki's cool. Nicki's cute. That's what it is. Her shit is cute, but it ain't real. And when you know, the bitch got a big ass.
Man. I don't listen to Nicki, so.
I mean, I listen to Nicki and be fucking. That's about it.
Man, let me tell you something. First of all, you guys, okay? Remy came in here. Not only did she talk about the ass shots and it popped and you couldn't fuck for that. By the way, Miss Dale, you ain't getting no box from her for 90 days and you a motherfucking celebrity, nigga. You a lame.
No. Are you fucking other bitches, nigga?
Well, no, he ended up fucking other bitches, but he wasn't getting no box from her for 90 days. And it's like, nigga,
and
you tolerated that from that bitch? Are you serious?
I mean, you got to, though.
No, you don't. You do. Everybody else left us so freaking off the fucking niggas.
And that is admirable, let's be honest. That's pretty admirable.
But right. You guys know that history, right?
Who?
Nicki and
Well, Remy said it in the song. No, thanks,
but
Remy.
You didn't see that post I seen it years ago. It was It was an old post, right?
Okay.
This is before Nicki got on. She used to be like a little stud.
Oh, right.
No, but I seen it years ago. She used to be a little stud.
And
you know?
She used to like eat out Remy.
They said Remy ate her out.
They said both.
I mean shit, they boxed.
So they hooked up?
I mean that's
what it was in the video. She was like, I ate the box, you know. I ate the box. She ate the box. Blah blah blah. Yeah.
Talking about
Remy. Yeah, both of them.
She's being stud, nigga.
So they hooked up.
Yeah,
this is years before. Yeah, like, they have history.
Yeah, and even in the run, she was saying, yo, you supposed to be Nicki Minaj. You ain't throwing no bad thoughts.
No bad thoughts.
And he was like, nah. She's like, oh, that's when I knew you was a trash box.
Wow.
Yeah, look at this.
New Mexico. Yo, my shit,
huh?
Bitch.
Yes.
First of all, she was like, you cokehead hoe. You cheated on your man with Ebro. They gassing you up, but you been on E, though. Pills and potions. Bitch, you been on E, ho. This is how crazy she did. This she said. She said, I'm the big homie. I'm Nicki Barnes. Call me the big homie. American gangster reference. Harlem drug lord. I'm Nicki Barnes. I'm the big homie. I'm Nicki Barnes. I responded. I'm getting money like Nicki Barnes. I'm the big homie. I responded in 48 hours. Nick Nolte. Get closer like Nick Jonas.
Nick Nolte.
With the gauge blazing. Face off, bitch. Nicolas Cage. That's when I fell on the floor. That's when I was like, stop it.
Nicolas
bitch,
Cage.
Stop it.
The wordplay.
Stop it.
Rambalushi?
She's like, you got your ghostwriter, so you think you lit. I'm Rambalushi. I'm a ghostbuster, bitch.
But here's the hard part.
There was no
Belushi Ghostbuster, though.
There was not. It was Dan Aykroyd, and I think that's the one she was thinking about. Yeah. And she was thinking of Jim Belushi Blues Brothers,
because
she was with Dan Aykroyd. But that shit was still cold, because you knew
and
she was...
John Belushi was supposed to be in it, but...
He was.
Rims and fit in Rims. I'm taking Rims back.
Hey,
all white people look
alike
sometimes.
Amen. Praise him. Check it out.
I'm not
letting
this
slide. No. First of all,
I got the sales numbers.
Okay, he got
that album sold 160,000 copies in the U.S.
Okay.
35,000 first week. That's not platinum.
Oh no, but it went worldwide.
It went platinum.
Oh, here we go. Now we're going worldwide.
No, but it went platinum.
Hey, listen, rounding off the platinum.
It went platinum.
I'm gonna go to RIAA to see if it's
the recording industry, other two levels.
But do you really think her career's over now?
Who? Nicki?
No.
I don't think it's over. I think she's definitely gonna take a hard hit because Nicki, even when she had her ghostwriters and all the shit, Nicki wasn't killing no bars like that. Like I would read like Twitter.
She'll say slick shit.
It was cute. Just, Twitter, they was dragging it. Like, watch Nicki come back and say, that's why your album flopped, Sandal. Like,
oh, no.
Her album flopped?
No, but they like, that's how her bars be. That's how your album flopped, Sandal.
That's cute. That's a cute bar.
It did, but listen,
that's a cute bar. That's a cute bar.
I mean, you know.
The album didn't go platinum, y'all.
Nigga.
Oh, man.
Remy. All the Way Up is in there, but that's it.
Oh,
Remy, there's something about Remy.
He's doing Remy research.
I got no Remy research. And that, you know,
I'm like, leave Remy this alone. How about that?
Huh?
Reminisce.
That's a real name. Reminisce math.
That I just found out.
I just want y'all to be accurate out here in these streets.
See, we appreciate actually, that.
That's what fucked up hip hop accuracy. Most words don't rhyme, but some niggas make words rhyme because they don't.
Kanye West be doing that. He be forcing the rhyme.
But honestly, like streetwise and to us, I think Nikki's on a down slope.
Hold on. Oh,
oh, most definitely.
Because it's going
to
cost
me. Most definitely. It's Pop Jenkins up in there. So, you know, she's going to have to go to Monster Nikki to even recover. She's going to have to drop another Monster verse.
No, she's going to have to start doing that voice again.
Yeah, whatever it takes.
That's the monster shit.
Whatever it takes.
But I don't think that's going to save her because that was cute in 09, 07, but it's 2017. Like, what I even posted today, like, because the first thing she did was try to post the numbers and all of that. And it's like, bitch, this hip hop. Yeah, nobody want to see that shit. Numbers. You know you got washed. She didn't told all your bitch. You had gonorrhea. This bitch talked about your brother.
It's a cute gonorrhea from just a fun one night stand. And you never knew.
You'll know.
Yeah, I mean, in the morning.
The males know.
In the morning.
Is that the drip? What is the drip?
Syphilis.
I don't know. I don't think I really want to find out. That's one of the light ones, though. If you had to pick some STDs again, you'd be like, chlamydia, gonorrhea. It'd be one of those two.
I would rather just get a UTI. Okay. Have some cranberry juice, a couple pills, and it's home.
Well, that's lightweight.
I'm saying on the A-list, STD list, you had to pick one. I don't want nothing.
We all want nothing, but if you gotta pick one, what you pick? We know this. Nobody wants any of them.
But if you had to pick one, I guess gonorrhea. It'd be chlamydia or gonorrhea. I don't want either. We don't want none of these. How about we just all use condoms and go raw when our test results get out?
I'm clean. I'm good to go.
Hey, I've been clean.
Hey,
and I want to stay that way.
Listen, I'm only clean.
I'm a virgin.
You've been bopping for three years, girl gone.
Hey, Frida.
Who is that?
My friend Frida.
Oh, they comment.
Yeah, we have Facebook Live.
Okay, we on podcast too. They're like, who the fuck is Frida?
She didn't turn your
Big show. Frida.
She turned your show into her show.
Sorry.
Yeah, you always gotta be doing
because
something.
People ask it.
She like the screen within a screen.
Yeah. I forget.
Okay, other than Remy.
Yes.
Is there any girls that can handle Remy?
Rhapsody.
Huh?
Yeah.
Rhapsody.
Who the fuck is that?
Rhapsody is underground. Like she
was on Kendrick Lamar's last album.
And she did some shit with King Los and some DJ Premier.
Like she's my favorite female in real life.
She's like literally the young incarnation of Lauryn Hill, if Lauryn Hill was a little more hood and a little more honest. Like, you know what I mean? And she don't raspy don't sing. So.
Okay.
Yeah, just straight.
I gotta check this chick out. Right?
Yeah.
Is she cute?
I don't know how she looks.
She probably nice.
Nah,
bitches with bars really ain't that cute.
Nah, man. If somebody was cute.
She was cute. MC Light was attractive, man. Lynn Q, MC Light, Yo-Yo was cute. Lady of Rage was cute. That's all it is. You ain't chasing this thing. That's back when you was chubby.
Yeah.
Exactly.
You had chubby attractions.
Though.
Nah, man. I'm talking about the face. Are we talking about the face or the whole setup?
He's talking about the Afro puff.
I ain't fucking no bitch.
Lady of Rage was not ugly, man.
I'm not fucking Lady of Rage. I'm a skinny nigga. No.
You guys trying to hold on to them pies?
No, nigga, no.
I mean, I
about that life.
I mean, if a bitch gonna cut me with her residual checks, yeah, I'll fuck for the dollar.
Then you had Charlie Baltimore.
I fuck.
You had
little Kim before
Jackie
she...
O. Y'all remember Jackie O?
I fuck.
Jackie
she had no o. ass. She had titties. She had too much titties.
Yeah.
I remember the name. I don't remember my what she name. Looked like. She. My, I don't know. I remember. Yeah, that was
oh, my bad. That's Kia. Yeah. But Jackie O did was cute too.
I remember her name. I can't remember what she did. Trina. Trina was this.
Oh, Trina's the name. I want to be Trina.
Trina's the bitch in the hood that I hang out with. Like, yo, get her number for me. I didn't want to fuck her.
That's your spirit animal?
Yeah, Trina. That's my spirit animal.
Oh, you talking about you a virgin bitch?
I'm Trina.
One of her first rounds was. One of Trina's first rounds was getting the dick down and let a bitch eat the clit. And that's your spirit animal.
And you don't know that.
And you don't know that.
That's what I'm talking about. I like the shit that Trina does. I just don't want to fuck Trina. She got some bad bitches around
me. I never really was lusting after Trina.
And I honestly, dog, I don't want no bitch that be fucking me and rapping at the same time. Bitch, just suck a dick.
Oh my gosh, that's hilarious. Bitch, just suck a dick.
Full of the savagery.
Yeah,
bitch, well, let's talk about this. I love this.
On the mic. Bitch, just suck it.
Let me.
Blah, 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 blah. Get the fuck out.
This is what I love. Hip-hop is misogynistic. Yeah. Can you admit that, fool?
I mean, first of all, I'm going to be totally honest.
Please.
I did graduate high school. But what? Give me a synonym for Ms. Harrell.
You know what that means.
Like just male.
Driven, yeah.
Male driven, male ruthless, like just.
Yeah, I think we honestly,
down women.
If you really want to be.
It is. I'm a woman. But and I can admit it, and I'm not admitting it from feel sorry for us. No, some of my favorite rappers, most of my favorite rappers are guys.
Yeah,
but it's real, and people be trying to act like it ain't real.
Right.
But that's what's the dope part about it. When you get a female that's that ill, that
like
nasty.
Remy.
Right.
I mean, there's a couple bitches that did it. Foxy did it.
Yeah.
She said, "Fuck, so what? Nigga, I'm sucking and fucking bitch," but she owns it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, niggas is killing niggas. They own it. I mean, hope they are. But you know what I mean.
Wait, that's some. I hope niggas is killing niggas.
I mean, I hope niggas is killing shit.
No,
I know what he means. This
you
know what I mean? Like, online like, about
you, yeah, yeah. Right. If you come in, you nasty, you got bars right. and all that, that's when gender doesn't matter.
Right.
Wait, nice is nice.
Remember Hurricane
Jane? Paul,
she was dope. Rob Digger was dope, too.
Paul, though.
Rob
Digger. Rob Digger was dope. Rob Digger, we met you. Come back, bitch.
Time out. She still spits. That's Jersey. So I realized the baddest bitches in rap came from Jersey.
Hey, man. I can't even. Lauryn Hill
is the best. That's why you threw that in there.
You goddamn right.
Lauryn Hill is the best of all time to me.
But seriously, Jonnae got like disturbed a little bit. She's like, wait a minute. You hope they kill. That means somebody died. Like, see,
I got it.
You don't want people to get killed, but you don't want.
But you
don't
want them to lie about.
Yeah,
exactly. I feel it. It's just
see,
my brain.
See, that was poetic.
Like,
you got to look under my words.
No, I feel it. I get what you mean. It's still
it was
scary.
Very poetic.
Oh yeah. While we got y'all here, right? I just pulled out of the fishbowl, and then I looked at the first thing. I was like, oh yeah, I didn't even ask y'all. So usually what we do every podcast, we try to find out who's everybody's like favorite rapper or who's somebody out there that everybody is hyping up, but you like, fuck them. I don't really fuck with them.
Okay, you want to go first?
Well, you said it, but my favorite hip-hop artist is Lauryn Hill. Like,
of all time.
Like, yeah.
Amen, praise
him, yes. I feel like, you know, she is a lot of times overlooked and people don't see that, but mm-hmm. I feel like she possesses many of the elements of hip-hop and she comes with it. Like, to me, hip-hop, the educational piece, I'm a nerd.
Me too.
That's such a piece of hip-hop that I love.
Mm-hmm.
And
Q-Tip got me interested in that first, like using words and we're like, yeah!
I like, and I mean, just she's somebody I can relate to the most. You know what I mean?
Right.
I love West Coast mm-hmm. hip hop, so anything Battle Cat touches, I'm probably gonna fuck with it. You know what I mean?
Amen.
I love Kendrick.
Amen.
J. Cole.
Yep.
I like.
Nigga,
I like
you like who everybody else like?
There we go.
Who everybody else?
I don't know if everybody. Does everybody like these guys?
Yeah,
yes,
much.
But
that's good.
But
yeah, all the people you named, you
that's
can't.
These are Tony's like this, yeah.
But
oh, okay.
Like that's just, yeah. I love storytellers.
Who,
right? Nas, the storyteller.
Who you think is overrated?
Who?
That people pump up that you like,
nah.
It's
hot garbage.
Yeah, it was hot. I don't even. Dej Loaf, I fucking hate her.
Okay,
I don't know why.
Talk about it.
Dej Loaf, number one, the haircut. Cause I don't know if she's a singer or a rapper. Like she looks like she should be in Total. Like that's
she do look like
one.
Old girl. Can't
it's just too much.
She looks like a lounge singer.
I don't like to me when she tried to rhyme family. She really tried to make that work. Is that a nigga trying to put a hex on his family? Like,
yeah.
Say family. That's I don't like that. Yeah.
That's what I'm doing this whole time.
Oh, Young M.A.N.? I don't like.
What?
I don't like.
You don't like Young M.A.?
Because okay, I don't like the confusion factor. Because okay. The first 9 times I heard that song, ooh, I was like, ooh, he sound fine. And then found out it was a chick. I don't like.
You know what it is? This is what I don't like. This is what I don't like.
You're not liking her because her rhyme. You just don't like her because her.
No. Wait. I like Young M.A., but this is what I will agree on with you. This is what I do agree with you. I hate that line when she goes, she made me weed when she deep though. Bitch, how? Bitch,
that part is like how you said, you want to know niggas is killing. I want to know you, how do you feel deep throat, Young M.A., and how? How do you feel it?
You got me.
Am I entitled to that?
Oh, yeah, you got
okay,
me.
Okay, here we go. It's like you still get a period, okay. Just like me. You still do. Don't front.
Do not
front.
Red lights around here.
I'm just saying, she needs to admit she got a red light. Is all I'm saying.
Like, don't confuse me and throw me off. Okay, I respect it. Okay. See, his was real. And I had to tell somebody about this like 2 podcasts ago. You gotta let people have their taste, because that's what hip hop is about. Hip hop was about diversity. It was about representation, authenticity. People just like what the fuck they like. Don't come to me and tell me my list is trash. Bitch, you ain't grow up with me. I purchased albums. Fuck you. You know what I'm saying? I made some niggas go platinum. I'm in the culture.
I was part of that.
Great. What's your list, baby?
I know you got some.
He texted his baby. He texted
her. What you got?
But this, all right. See, honestly, I take rap very serious.
You're at the right place.
Very serious. Welcome. So, I'm not going to front. Jay's my all-time favorite. Okay. But my favorite, like, I got to pick my list.
Yeah.
Is going Red.
Red Man?
Yes.
Nice. Yeah.
Ghostface.
Okay.
Slick Rick.
Okay.
Are we going to go, you know what?
We had Dana Dane here.
Oh, what the fuck out of
here? We did. We had a Dana Dane here from the Kango crew. But he went to high school with Slick Rick. They was in the together.
I fuck with them niggas.
So you need to go back and listen to episode 3. Okay.
I will.
Go ahead and plug the podcast in the podcast. Okay. Go listen to episode 3. Okay, and then you say Slick Rick.
Slick Rick, on some West Coast shit, or just some real shit. What's my nigga name? Pimp Nigga.
Who?
Sugar Free?
Sugar Free.
Oh, okay.
Sugar Free just spitting, nigga. He said that bullshit.
Wait.
If you got fucking was holes and all that shit, he can rhyme.
You gotta put a disclaimer in there, usually they can't rhyme.
You were behind fucking hoes. No, because I'm disclaiming. You can rhyme. The disclaimer went with your features, because you get your face frowned up.
Time out. Yo, when you said Pimp Nigga, I actually thought that was his name. I was like, who's out there Pimp Nigga? What the fuck?
Sugar Free, Pomona's
Fire. And rounding up the new niggas that I really like, I fuck with that nigga Freddie Gibbs.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I fuck with Freddie Gibbs hard boy. Real hard.
Who you think overrated, though?
Shit, the list gonna go. I mean, put it like this.
Keep it real. Put it's like your this. List.
Okay, there's a lot of people overrated, and there's a lot of people who's like, nigga, you corny. And, he just had a song I liked. J. Cole, I think he's a bit overrated. He's good, but he's overrated.
Mm-hmm. I do, too. I think people overhype. I like what he does. Yeah. And this is the perfect way to say, I appreciate him. I appreciate who he is and what he does. But people be coming up, like talking about him like, he has changed the game for Duke. And I'm like, no, he's not. Okay. He's just good.
Okay, my second one, Tony might be mad at me.
Oh, who?
This was saying about Tony.
I know, but Tony my nigga.
Tony ain't the guardian of hip hop.
I am.
I am.
You sitting on the edge like a gargoyle. Like, say something wrong.
You know, we talk about this.
Where you going with this?
Lupe.
I can't be mad at you.
Lupe a little, you know what I mean?
You thought he was going to be mad because we from Chicago? Yeah, exactly. We already know what it is.
Only flare up with niggas diss Nas pretty much.
Oh, no. My bad. Nas is in the bucket, too. I apologize.
Okay,
all right. Nas is in the
bucket. We good.
In the good bucket.
In the good bucket.
Okay, all right. He should be, though.
Yeah. I mean.
He had a 20-year career.
Like, you know, so crazy. I'm one of them weird niggas. Like, I like this mumble rap for certain situations, but this shit's overrated.
For situations. That's how you
situation. But I fuck with you.
That's what we all said. Like, I mean, like I said, no, I fuck with Future.
Never
know. I fuck with
No, he enunciates.
But, I mean, sometimes.
Future.
Future, sometimes.
He enunciates.
Oh,
Sometimes.
But like with the Young Thug, the Verdes, and anybody else little. You know this? I have a thing with anybody that's little.
Or young.
Or young.
Yeah.
Now, they don't want to grow up.
Anybody with Big and Murder, I fuck with.
So you like Uncle Murder?
That's my name.
What about Murder?
Yeah.
Murder.
Nah.
And that was a label. That wasn't your name.
We'll go with, I'm sorry, I'm glad you said it. With the new niggas?
Yeah, Uncle Murder.
Gibbs and Murder.
Uncle Murder. He is quotable. Like, he got punchlines for days. That's what I like about him. Like, the first time I heard him, I was like, yo, this motherfucker, like, he
is like old. How his name is grown, though. Yeah, Uncle Murder.
Yo.
You sound old, but Uncle.
No, you, okay, so listen to his, like, rap. Like rap from 2016.
I'm gonna see you some
like the nigga, like he's dope.
Oh, and another,
he's one of the people. Oh, he's from Brooklyn.
He's from East New York. And one more, my last upcoming nigga that I fuck with. He's from the West Coast. This nigga named Mozzie.
I haven't heard of him.
Mozzie.
Okay,
Mozzie from Sacramento.
Okay,
blood.
He could be whatever you want. He with the shit.
What about Locksmith?
I like Locksmith.
He does sound white.
No.
He's black.
A lot of
cats
that
got
bars.
He's
from the Maine.
Like, rapper.
Is he bar rapper?
He's more
hood.
He's more hood. So he's like a backpack
rapper.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Hey, he don't like the backpack.
I mean, I appreciate them. And I listen to this shit. I just ain't riding to this shit. That ain't the shit you want when you get pulled over and you know you got warrants.
I love you.
I need that.
I love you because you're
yourself. I need Mozzie. When I get pulled over, I go warrants. I know I'm going back to county. I need to be in that mind frame. Like, I got one of these little dirty niggas from LA going to try to test me. You know what I mean? Or before I go to Wasteland, some niggas going to test me. I realize it. You know what I mean? But honestly, if you really listen to Mozzie, he's a hood nigga, but the nigga really knows rap. He can really spit. You may not care about the things he talk about, but his form, his patterns, his everything, his lyrical skill, is all that, and he will shoot you.
I'm all about well-roundedness when it comes to content. A lot of people lump me in the, you gotta be positive all the time.
That's what I thought you were.
I need the well-rounded. Like, if you always talking about murder, I get bored, because I know you're not killing niggas out
but
here.
But if you're talking about positivity,
how are you out
making albums if you're murdering all these people, dog?
How you know you ain't a
hero? And why are you telling on yourself? Like, I can't respect it at the end of the day. But like, because if I kill somebody, I'm not mentioning it on wax. I'm going to be talking about uplifting the community, being a pastor. I got 8 bodies in the basement. I'm not incriminating myself. But like,
I agree with that.
Yeah, you.
Your left hand can't know what your right hand is doing.
Talk, I murdered this nigga. I murdered that nigga. Yeah, people are like, oh, you did? Yeah. They going to tell the cops.
Oh, and
well, they going to kill you themselves.
I'm like, my 50 cousin. Fan. I'm a 50.
You shouldn't.
I like his pettiness.
You sound like him too.
But are you a fan of the music?
Oh, fuck.
You should be. Katie Tate was tight. Katie Tate, can we have people playing?
The last one he put out.
The Katie mixtape was tight.
It was hot.
With nigga, you ain't saying nothing. With Young Buck, that shit was cold. Yeah. 9 Shots. That was the one where I'm the man.
You must know what they mail in his residuals. Huh? You know too
much. I listen to the shit. Okay, I'm with the shit, fool.
Yeah. You like rappers?
I like everything.
What do you mean?
I feel like
you too liking everything. What don't you like?
No. I am not too liking everything. So, I don't like. Hold up.
Who?
Okay.
Hold up.
Non-winners.
No. Wait. Here's the thing. Wait, there we go. Chief Keef.
Okay. There we go.
I get like what Chief Keef like represented. I mean, here's the thing. Like real niggas like Chief Keef because they were in that element, so they understand him, right? And there's this one song he got that about talking about the niggas in Jersey, like when they sang.
That song is so hard, but I don't like that song.
Yes, because it's talking about Jersey. He can't come to Jersey no more. So they made this song about like, we gonna let me come to, nigga, I'ma set it up, I'ma kill everybody.
He said, I'ma go to do a show and I'ma light in Jersey up.
I'ma light it up.
Why is the band from Jersey?
This is what happened. He came out to Elizabeth, which is right next to North. And the nigga came like mad late. Like, I'm talking about like, the club closed at like 2.
Yeah.
And the nigga showed up like 1:45. And then he wanted the rest of his money and niggas didn't like that. Then the crowd was a bunch of Greek Street niggas. You know what I mean? And them niggas, they ran them out.
Okay. You play that shit in Chicago in a club? Nigga, it's pandemonium. It like, for real. And I don't fuck with Keith. I fuck with that song.
I'm fucking with that song.
I wasn't really into the... Nah, he got his
stuff. He wasn't paying attention to.
Yeah. Well, see, I never really gravitated toward him either. Yeah. I wasn't really feeling the shit either. But I am, like I said, I'm a fan of rap. I'm a fan of bars. I'm a fan of music. And I'm a purist in the sense of... I understand what hip-hop is. Hip-hop is an organism. Hip-hop has always been a representation of the speaker, whoever right. they are.
Yeah.
So like you said, if you are killing people and that's what you're really about, okay, fine, I'll let you have it in the bars. I can't listen to your music if that's all you talk about. Right. But if you really live that life, nigga, I can at least respect it because at least you being yourself.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? It's still the same. Like Grandmaster, it's like a jungle sometimes. It made me wonder how I came from. That shit was real
nigga,
shit.
Nigga, that's
it was real shit.
That's one of the hardest verses ever.
Exactly, oh, but that was real shit. And that's why NWA was who they was, because it was right. real shit. I always fuck with Cube. Cube is one of my favorites, and people don't mention him enough.
And would you get Cube? Would you get Cube, sir?
Yes!
Wait, what happened?
No question.
What was the question?
Would I get Q song? Yes. Oh, okay. In his heyday, like, I don't know if I would give old Q songs.
But he looked the same.
He looks the same.
I like my niggas in shape. Look, I'm
jealous. Q was never in shape.
I know.
When he was Doughboy,
he was cuter. I don't know. He was
funnier. Oh, you like the girl.
Yeah, I do. I wanted the girl. Her core fan base was from overseas, and that like kept her working, and she was building momentum. Iggy Azalea stole her name. They beefed over the name, and you know Iggy Azalea had the machine and T.I. and all that shit behind her. She went further. But
I fucked the shit out of Iggy Azalea before the ass. Before nigga, I like my white bitch is traditional flat ass nigga.
I love
like traditional white bitch.
I love traditional white ass.
See what I'm saying? I never, once I like heard her music, I got it, but I never was like, okay,
yeah.
This is dope and she gonna be around. And then when she started shooting her own self in the foot, I was like, bitch, go away.
Yeah.
I never was feeling that. I wasn't an Iggy fan. I saw through that gimmick immediately. I only liked the one where she was like, gotta get it out while live. I've been up all night. That shit was dope.
I can't remember trying to get that work.
That shit was cold.
Cause you don't go to club. You don't go to club.
Yeah, I club.
That's why I don't know.
Not necessarily, but I don't live in the club. I live in the car. I live walking. I live in the crib, like, so I listen to that type of music.
Boring.
There has to be no incense, but the club is whack to me. It's just a whole bunch of people that don't do anything.
Hollywood clubs are whack to me. I hate Hollywood.
I like house parties.
I love house parties. But there are some clubs that that give that effect. And you also don't go to strip clubs either.
No.
See, that's another reason why.
I go to strip clubs, but I don't give away tax-free money.
Amen, praise.
So what do you do when you're there?
You got to watch. You watch. There's music. It's entertaining.
Rule number one, you want to get a stripper, bitch, you don't tip. You don't tip. You talk, you chill. The bitch might think you corny because you ain't tipping her. But wait, that bitch out, she's gonna respect you because you ain't tipping. I ain't no trick, bitch.
Yeah.
I like you.
Now what's up?
I like you. And then, you know, they eat that shit.
Nothing. I like you.
But it worked, though.
I can't stand you.
Because they used to everybody just seeing their bodies and seeing them as an object. You hit them with that and fuck their head up.
I like you. Let's do something.
Yeah.
He repeated it for the...
Why does that sound like that's a poem you give? give a bitch on Valentine's Day. I like you. I like what you're doing, though.
I mean,
the way you make it clap, I like that.
I like that.
But strip clubs is, honestly, it's the energy, and nigga, if you've been Atlanta once, it's other people, you can play pool, you know what I mean?
Yeah. You know who else I don't like?
You ever play pool with a naked bitch at the same time?
That's dope.
Stimulating.
Exactly.
Yeah, I'm telling you, it's entertaining. I'll tell you the girl end of it. Like, but another part, I'm not really into YG like that. And because we in Cali, he's Surf always
songs.
On the radio.
Yeah.
I really only like the one he did with Drake. Like every time I hear YG, it sounds like the continuation of the same song I heard him on the last time.
Okay.
It's like an endless loop of like lowrider music.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Touche. What about the song Meet the Neighbors? Meet the Fockers. What about Meet the Fockers?
Meet the Fockers.
The Flockers. When he was talking about robbing Asian motherfuckers in Robin House, it was a nice storytelling. It was lyrical within his shit.
See, I don't like him so much, I didn't even delve into his collection because he turned me off.
I give niggas a chance to start shit.
I try.
I don't listen to YG. I just don't really listen to him. I be giving this album the iTunes preview off.
I give you 3-4 songs. If you can't reach me, I pass.
And it's not necessarily the West Coast flow. It's like, because I like Nipsey Hussle. But like, YG just never got me, though.
I'm like, I'm good.
You know who's debatable? Like, you a corny dude, but you do good shit, but you a corny dude? When it comes to his rhyming, shout out to Gambino.
Oh yeah.
He can spit, but he's a corny nigga.
Of course. But
that's what makes him dope because he's not trying to be nobody.
Yeah.
Right. Like, that's what I like.
I give him that.
Yeah.
That's
what I like. Be yourself.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so, because we don't want this to go too long, we're going to do a couple things. I'm going to pull one more thing from the fishbowl. I want us to go around the table. We started doing this like 4 episodes back, and now I have us do it every. You can't have a hip hop podcast without a cypher. Right? We're not trying to be rhymers though, but what I like us doing is paying homage to bars that we enjoy, like shit that we heard either coming up, growing up, this was my shit in high school or whatever, or some shit that you heard last year, whatever, that you hit the rewind button, like what the fuck they say, and just paying homage to those bars. And it's so much fun, because like hip hop, the origin of it is love. Like when you hear hip hop, you want to share that shit. Like, the way I came into hip-hop and loved it, it was on some sharing shit. Motherfuckers, yo, you up on that, man, you gotta listen to this, da-da-da-da-da. Yeah. Like, so...
What was your first hip-hop concert? How about that?
That's my first concert?
Your first concert, show, whatever.
Ooh, shit.
Wu-Tang.
Ooh, the first concert. Here's what's real. My first concert, real shit, was Common, because Common's mom was my principal.
Oh, wow.
And he performed.
Damn.
Oh,
that's really? Crazy.
Shout out to Thomas A. Hendricks and Common. Shout out to Hendrix Academy. Shout out to Mahalia Ann Hines.
She on the cover of his album cover.
Yeah, that's shout out. That was my principal. Mahalia Ann Hines. Shout out to her. Yeah, he came to perform. This was like right before the Resurrection album.
It was early in the game.
Oh, that was
right after he dropped out of college and was like, I'm gonna do this rap shit. And but he had in the Resurrection video, there was my classmate breaking in his video.
I love that Resurrection video. I love that.
But yeah, so that was my first one, but like the one I paid for.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Shit. I used to go to Taste of Chicago, and they would throw concerts all the time. I feel like, hell yeah, that's how you get on.
It's so packed.
I felt like, I don't know if Erykah Badu counts, but it was Erykah.
Yeah.
She was part of SoulFly. She's a singer.
She's a singer.
If we can't count Erykah, it would be Lauryn Hill. I went to Smoking Grooves. I saw Lauryn Hill, Roots, Outkast, and Jurassic 5.
That's the same one.
You were there?
Yeah, the San Diego one. The San Diego one.
Yes!
That's a good-ass lineup. Yes.
That was fire.
It was epic.
It was fire.
I can say, before Lauryn got on all the weird shit, showing up late, before the long-ass hiatus.
She had to,
before. When she was
on the guitar.
I'm
yeah.
school Lauryn.
But,
really?
You her age?
What?
You said I went to school with her.
We had gym together. I was a freshman. She was a senior.
Oh. Wow. That's historic.
That is.
Man. I seen all that. Do like home. She's do soap operas. We knew she was gonna blow.
Yeah, she was.
We thought she was gonna blow up actor.
She can act, man. She was just an act too. She killed it.
Yeah. My first concert. This is. I'm not that old, but I used to do dumb shit to get out the house. My mom worked that night. So my first rap concert was UTFO.
Okay. Wow. That's like 84. Yo.
They went up in there.
Wow, yo. Like, I used to clown
I shouldn't, but like this, I shouldn't have been there.
Yeah. Right.
I shouldn't have been there. Does it say that? I shouldn't have been there. I was too young, but my mom was blowing. That's why I like, but hip hop, I really treasure that shit. Like, I can't tell you shit about a textbook and all that shit.
Yeah.
I can tell you shit about hip hop, though.
This is called Hip Hop Raised Me. Like, dude, it was really my babysitter for a period of time. In real life, because my parents worked all the time. So me and my sisters, we were latchkey kids. My brother was...
Same here.
Yeah, my brother was like 9 years older than me, so he was already out fucking bitches doing his thing in the world. But we would get off the bus, we would come home, I would always cut on the TV, I would cut on Rap City, I would watch The Box, and I would just sit there.
Did y'all have Ralph McDaniels?
Was it?
Y'all didn't have Ralph. Oh, y'all ain't from the East Coast. Y'all don't know about Ralph McDaniels.
No, like,
That's like really, like, that's what everybody
Chris,
their
Chris,
video.
What's his name?
Ralph McDaniels.
Chris, no, Chris was...
Nah, it's better
Chris than Thomas.
Chris Thomas was the host of My Pleasure.
This is deeper than that.
Damn.
This is deeper. Like, everybody from Trust Area, they know about Ralph McDaniels and Music Box. Like, you know, you had your TV?
Yeah.
You had the dial up here, the U dial?
Yeah.
You had to put on the zero and go to U and put on 31.
Wow. That's UFC television. Right. That's like that old, like, that R-ATV.
Channel 66. Yeah.
Local access shit. This shit was like the biggest shit in Tri-City when it came like fuck a Rap City. We was doing that.
Music Box. Yo. That's the way to represent.
Yo.
Yeah. Okay.
Look up Ralph McDaniels. He's like the icon of hip hop.
Ralph McDaniels. Yo. That name is funny.
I used to just sit in front of the television, do my homework, and I'd be watching all
the
shows.
Let me tell you something. I lived on BET. I just kept the channel on BET. I watched that whole Rap City video,
Video Vibrations.
Madeline Wood on Video LP. But I would
turn it down to your MTV Raps.
Yeah, I went there too. I would go to MTV because MTV videos look crisper on MTV.
Yeah.
Than they did on BET. Yeah.
The best thing about your TV.
Because they would debut it. That's how you saw Ann Lover and
The best thing about your TV Raps is when it went off and had that big ass cipher. When they got on the air and everybody like they from.
I remember the episode. I can't remember who they had.
Nigga, they had everybody.
I'll look for it on YouTube. I remember they went out with a bang though.
They went out with a bang.
They went out with a huge ass bang. So let's get to these bars though. Like, think of like something, a song that you want to pay homage to. Like just your favorite rhyme. Like something like I remember this shit backwards and forwards. Cause we're not trying to make it hard. We're not rappers. We just want to pay homage.
See, the thing is, I'm one of them niggas, when I used to recite the bars, I was every year of the word with my shit. So
that's fine.
I can tell you the song. I can't tell the bars.
Get on down.
I'll give you two. Learn to Live with Regret by Jay-Z. That was the last song on his first album. And Whose World Is This Remix by Nas.
Okay.
Oh, the remix.
The world is yours. The world is yours. It's mine.
This is the remix. They even did a remix. He did like two different verses on it.
Okay. I sit the Don P watching Gandhi till I'm charging, writing in my book of rhymes all the word past the margin. Amen.
The thing is, I'm like, this nigga knows about margins.
What he knows about margins?
I ain't even think about rhyming margin with shit.
Right?
That's the thing. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
The murderers move.
Well, come on, the thieves thing. Play me at night, they won't act right. The things of hip hop has got me stuck like a crack pipe. The mind activation. Chasing time like Patty Mason.
I'm embracing, wipe the sweat off my dome.
Flip on the street.
The details, though.
Yeah.
Cinematic.
Got the Timbs on my feet, make my cipher complete. Brother cruising in the city cab. Oh, Montero Jeep, I can't call it. The beat got me falling asleep, I keep falling. But never falling 6 feet deep. I'm out for presidents to represent me. Say what?
I'm out for presidents to represent me.
Get money.
You see what I'm saying? Don't that feel good? Don't that feel good? It feel like love.
Come on.
Jonnae, what's your song?
All right. here we are. El Boogie once again.
Girl, get on that. I was going to do it all the time. No
play. I thought you were going to say Guaple.
Guaple?
Guaple, hey.
Guaple's one of the best songs ever. I don't know. Okay, it's side note. It's like just a little quick one, but okay. I don't know. That's what, why this always gets. When I met you last night, baby.
You talking about it ain't no fun?
Your mouth. Yes, I know why that.
Oh, you gave me. Oh, you pussy. Ain't no fun.
I don't know why.
Ain't no fun.
My bone.
That's just like never comes on. It's just like my whole spirit. Like, yeah.
You know what's so funny?
Shout out to Nate, y'all.
She
rocks
with me.
She's a preacher's kid.
She's talking about sucking dick. That's her favorite song.
That's
sucking dick.
That's a misconception.
Listen, there is a thing, soulful ratchets exist, okay?
Yeah. Anytime you
get
it, it's soulful ratchet
bitches. Don't get it.
Come on, man.
Soulful ratchet bitches, they stick their head up at me and then they give me a chance, like, oh.
They out here.
This nigga just got good dick.
So, wait.
Trip to get paper style bearing pack of flavor like flavor. Ain't that something? Talk shit and I'm dumping. I had your whole fucking block bumping. Don't sweat, detect the technique. I'm unique like China. You never find a bottom round in this nigga behind you. So pick a boot, clear the way. I'm coming through. One, two, three. You can't see me. I'm a G like that. Strap with his hard tactics. A fucking menace. Using hoes like tennis rackets. On again. It's on and popping. All I see is green, so it ain't no stopping. I want to see some panties dropping. I'm coming from L.A. Shoot some chill with Dre up in front.
That's Doggy Dog World.
But
it's
listen,
a crazy mix up world.
You know what? East Coast, you know, East Coast can still clean that nigga, right?
Bad.
Because he's a Philly dude. He grew up in Philly. Didn't look that dude.
I'm dishing my blues. I'm going to sit like bad news. Cut off khakis, French braids, and house shoes. Corrupt.
Hey, y'all done took me all over the map. I love this.
Corrupt are real bars. See, that was like a more of a radio play song. But you go into his albums.
Oh, man, he's super. Bars. Barred up.
You know,
I like his beat selection a lot of times.
I know what I'm going to do. Because I wanted to do like Lauryn Hill, Guantanamera, but y'all done took me with the Corrupt.
Where you at?
Y'all done took me over here with the Nas. I'm going to represent Q. I'm going to go with...
OG.
I'm gonna go with Lethal Injection Cube, 1993.
Okay, what was the song? I'm gonna
Oh, that's Natural Born Killer with Tupac in the video. With Tupac killed Ice Cube in the video. But that's neither here nor there. I'm gonna do from 1993 Lethal Injection.
Today was a good day, though.
Nah. To G you or not to G is the question. And like Smith told Wesson, I'm shady with that 380 old school diploma. I leave that ass in a coma. So if you got a herringbone, welcome to the Terror Dome 211. Sorry, Reverend. Oh my God, getting robbed. Reach for the small atomic dog. Hard to swallow, janky ass wallow. Count to 10. And don't try to follow, cause just like Waco, I could take 4 ATF. To they death, bust a left on Western, go and get a room, don't wanna be a felon like Stacey Goon. Hit the light switch, get the right bitch, here we go. Tap that ass like this, really though. Believe in something, West Side Lynch, like mom. Why not believe in me? That was his flow though.
But no, you said you put in your flow.
Yeah, but that was his flow, yeah. Yeah. 30 in the home take, smell the vapors, make me a pillow out of toilet paper. Yeah.
You was hard, man.
You was hard.
You was that dude.
Call that call from the mama. My mama said, please don't call her. Do I diddy? Far from New Jack City, seen one of my peers. What the fuck you doing in here? He said 187 on that interview, and they treat me like I just shot a Kennedy. Deputy bitch think she's the queen bee. Ink on my thumb, index and peaky. Sir, what set your flum? Put dumb general pop you. They shun. This nigga told stories. Mama put the house up so I could bounce up out this motherfucker. That's why I love you. Listen, I used to ride my bike. Summer of 93 with my headphones on, just listening to Lethal Injection because nobody know I was listening to it. Because my mama took my salt and pepper tape away from me because she thought that was like,
oh man, it was light work.
Yeah, right, you see what I'm saying? I had salt and pepper.
I had
two apocalypse now. I had Strictly for My Niggas because this is all like 93. I had Very Necessary, Salt and Pepper. I had Queen Pen.
Hold on.
Random.
She can rap, man. She can rap. But yo,
and I had Lethal Injection.
I would never let my daughter listen to Salt and Pepper. They first single was Push It. They're talking about fucking.
I mean, and then, but
you don't let your daughter listen to
that. She took Very Necessary. That was What a Man With a Man. That was Shoop. That was What a Man With a Man. That was Shoop. That was the song that she heard. Oh, none of your business.
No, but they had, Salt Pepper had messages though.
They did.
They talking about sex.
They had messages. But the song that was playing that I had in my room that she heard from Salt Pepper was, I just said it, with, none of your business. If I want to take a guy home with me tonight, it's none of your business. And if she want to be a pregnant, it's
your mom. I'm your mother.
She came, what the hell is your mother? And she took my Salt Pepper, she took my Salt Pepper tape and my Queen pen. But that left Pac and Q, because I hid those, she ain't have it. So I was like,
that's funny.
I'm going to wear my headphones for now. She ain't going to even know.
That's funny. Yeah.
Real story.
That episode like hot cake.
Hey, amen.
Which one?
Very Necessary.
It did.
Oh, yeah.
That was like they best seller.
Four mil.
Okay, so let's get a Tony Baker pick of the week.
Oh, the pick of the week, man. Sky Zoo and Apollo Brown.
Hey, amen.
Sky Zoo
and Apollo. The rappers?
No, Sky Zoo is the rapper. He's from New York. And Apollo Brown's a producer, so they did a joint album. So Apollo did all the beats, Sky's doing the mic, and it's called One in the Same, featuring Patty Crane.
And a bit card works, and how we thought it the same, and you get caught in the aim on my side by sides, birdies on a Hail Mary like la da da.
Man, like I'm out, we'll be in a random conversation and Tony will bring up something. It's like, dude, how did you have time to find them? Where are they? Who are they? I ain't never heard of this dude. So,
Sky Zoo.
He's been on Lil Brother albums. He's been around for a while.
That's
he was on the minstrel show.
Okay. See, but I'm like,
if it ain't in the club, you ain't listening to.
I listen to everything, though. I dip and dab. That's what I do. That's what I do. Okay, so we're going to do our segment, Kudos to Kiki. So I got a few kudos, and I really only got like two kill yourself. Okay, first, my kudos goes to Remy Ma. Come on, guys, wait. Remy showed the fuck up and showed out, and
let her know she still got it.
Yo, dude, like I told them,
because on the way up,
I responded in 48 hours, Nick Nolte. that Nick Jonas get closer, Blaze with the gauge, face off, bitch, Nicolas Cage. Come on, y'all not spitting these bars like that, little Uzi.
I still don't like the flow on this track, but you know.
I think that's why I like it.
Yeah, it's just effortless. It's like, I'm just fucking.
I like that.
Just talk, man. Just get on the podcast.
But also, tell us this.
You got to put some energy into the delivery.
I understand what you said, but I think she wanted to make sure you could understand everything. I want you to get all of this.
That's fine.
I want you to hear. I'm going to say it slow. I'm going to do all of that. So she gets the kudos. Also, kudos goes to Jordan Peele. Yeah, Jordan Peele, because I was King and Michael Key. But Get Out. $30 million this weekend.
That's what's up. I ain't fucking with white bitches for at least a month.
Hilarious.
Did you see?
At least a month. Yeah, that's the first night it came out.
We had black themed scary movies in a minute. I think we was talking. Yeah, I'm trying to go see it.
It's good.
I want to see it. Let's go see it. I was going to go see it, and like the numbers came out today, and I was like, God damn, they did it.
Good. You know what it felt like? It felt like
kudos to y'all. I got one more kudos to you.
Listen, I felt like that movie was written by an angry black woman that had her husband took by a white bitch.
But it was written by Jordan Peele.
No, I know, but as you went, you saw it, right?
That's why I wanted to.
God damn, it's a creative black bitch behind this story.
It's a Shonda Rhimes in here.
The audience response in the theater was crazy. There was a lot of claps in there.
Yeah.
And I've been in Burbank, they ain't really like an energetic theater audience in there.
Right.
They was clapping. They was like,
what they clapping?
They was clapping.
Nah, don't say that.
Yeah, I can't really.
Listen, why the
flag ladies
gotta be last for shit? You know what I mean?
You know what?
Who was supporting us?
I wait. I went to go see.
Ryan
was waiting
for the box office result.
No, yeah. I did not.
I'm gonna see how many tomatoes they got.
Yeah. It got 100%. It was certified fresh. Don't do me like that. I went to see Birth of a Nation. I went to go see all the shit. I be seeing all that shit.
I went to go see
Hidden Figures.
Did you go?
I was in Vincent.
Did you go see I'm a Negro?
No, I have not seen it. I thought it was on Netflix, but I'm gonna check it out.
Cause you don't want to do the facts about blacks.
No, you know what? You gonna stop trying to make this about some bullshit.
So what's your other kudos?
My other kudos actually goes to Swiss Beatz and Just Blaze for the producer battle that they kicked off this weekend.
Really?
Yes.
They already had the battle?
Yes. Oh my God. So you know what? I didn't catch it because they did it on IG Live. But what happened was I just missed it. But I was like, just knowing that it happened, I watched the post on Swiss Beatz page, because it happened on Friday. The post that happened, I watched Swiss Beatz page, Just Blaze page, the comments that they made before they did it. Before, I don't know, because Just Blaze got crazy hi-hats. But Swiss Beatz puts out hits.
No, so, nigga, what? Just Blaze don't got hits?
I ain't say he ain't got hits. I said he got crazy hi-hats, goddammit.
No, he didn't say he got hits.
But
he's
a different thing. Just Blaze. You gotta say hits.
Just Blaze got hits. Just Blaze got hits. He do got hits. The song he produced, the one song he produced on Beyonce's album, is my favorite.
Okay.
Like,
which song?
Freedom. That was Just Blaze. Them the drum, like the reason I can always tell a Just Blaze.
Oh, that's the one with Kendrick?
Yes. Oh, I can always tell a Just Blaze beats because of his snare patterns in the drum.
Okay.
Like Jay-Z, oh my God, hoes. That's Just Blaze.
Right.
He always has like the snare. But anyway, the fact that they did that for the culture, I think is so dope. It's very hip hop, and that's something everybody wants to see, and they want to keep it going. They called out Pharrell and Timbaland. Okay. They want to keep it, yes, see? Ooh. See,
Timbaland take a lot of
niggas out. That's what I'm saying. So they're doing it for the culture, and it took over Twitter. It trended and was like number one. I guess Just Blaze won, because his name was one and Swiss Beatz was three. It was Just Blaze, Another Thing Trent, and Swiss Beatz was three. And then Pharrell was trending four because they called out Pharrell and Timbaland. But I guess everybody like, Pharrell, get in this.
Yo.
So, but they did that for the culture, and kudos. I'm mad I missed it. I heard about
it. Straight missed it.
And I was sad. That was epic.
That's dope. That's an I'll go see live.
Right. I want them to take it on the road. Like,
you know what? And they could probably got some hip hop over there.
Take it Take, you know what? He all about the hip-hop hoes.
He about
doing that thing.
These women that like hip-hop and bars, they good in bed, y'all.
I know.
They fuck on the third day.
They out here.
I mean, I don't agree with that Nike Day shit anyway. If we grown and we got some chemistry, we can work this out. Look.
Hey, I want the bitches fucking with no chemistry. What the hell?
Oh, okay. Hey, man. You just want bitches with...
That's fun.
Okay, I don't know about the chemistry. You just want them to have the look, okay, so the Kill Yourselves goes to number one, Nicki Minaj.
Yeah, she gotta kill herself.
She gotta kill herself. She gotta kill herself. No, I'm not gonna tell you. She got to kill herself. Because Nicki Minaj, this ain't her first encounter with rappers that, you know, she shitted on that she had beefs with. And off the bat, like her posting her numbers and like trying to be out, I'm like, bitch. If you don't come with some bars, Nicki, I'ma stop fucking with you.
She
gotta kill herself until she come with some bars. This is what I'm saying. I actually like go to bat for Nicki in the sense that she is a woman that has been holding a prominent place in hip hop. Like you said, she has cute bars. She does do. You know, like when she gets down and she don't play around with it and she's not being corny, she delivers. So I need her to step up on this. And so until she, I've been checking her, like I tweeted about it this morning. I've been checking her social media page, like I'm looking for residual checks. Like, bitch, is it here? Like, bitch, where are we at? Bitch, is it here? Because if she tries to run from this, I'm going to be upset. That's number one. Number two, I want to kill Ebro. Ebro at High 97, kill yourself today.
What did he do?
I'm about to tell you. Let me tell you something. No, I don't want to kill him for that. I want to kill him because of the beef he had with Pop. Not the beef. It's not beef. Let me say that. I want to kill him for the back and forth he had with Papoose this morning.
Papoose is smacking now.
Like, side note, please, can Papoose just tag team and get in this? On the low, he is an underrated beast and will go bananas.
But the nigga
please.
Will put hands on you in a heartbeat.
Papoose, exactly. Let me tell you, not only is he a real dude like that.
A real dude.
He's a real dude. Why would you marry a woman that shoots bitches in the stomach if you wasn't about that?
Why Papoose and Ebro going at?
Okay, so this is what happened. So Ebro,
they've been going about it for a couple months or a year. They've been at work.
Oh,
but this is why he on the Kill Yourself list today. Okay, so Remy drops a song. Remy says you cheated on your man with Ebro. Ebro comes out and be like, Remy, no, this is what he tweeted. Remy, no, she lying. She knows she lying.
You got a wife.
Remy knows she lying. Remy knows she lying. Blah blah blah. But that track was hot though. Whatever. So Papoose is like, Remy lying, but you text me yesterday telling me you happy as hell she said it. Bro, sit down. I was like, oh, so you're lying. Why would you? Because Ebro didn't have to say nothing. Like, the shit was out. But if somebody, you know, he could be like, you know what I'm saying? You play it down. He was like, no, she lying, blah, blah, blah. So publicly, like, to do all of that, you was doing a whole lot. So Papoose is like, but she was happy as hell. You texted me and said you was happy as hell. Then Ebro responds. I mean, I was. Who wouldn't be? So you gonna bring on the show or what? Nigga, just tell yourself. Why you even jump out there?
He's funny. He's a funny acting dude.
From
what I seen of him.
She made you look like the man, though, low key, like throwing you in there, and it's like, damn, Ebro was getting it. Damn, Ebro was tapping, blah blah blah, skippy boo.
You got a wife.
I mean, but she don't have.
That's what I'm saying.
That's just raps.
Nigga, that's just trifling in you.
Hold on, you married? You gotta put out the fight.
He ain't married. Bitch. He got a baby mama.
I thought they were married.
No, I don't think he got married. Ebro always said he was against marriage because he don't like the contract. I think he's married. That was like a year and a half ago. That's all I'm gonna say though. I'm like, what me, y'all? That was a year and a half ago. Maybe they married. I couldn't be wrong about that. Fucking Ebro the rapper. Ain't no Ebro the rapper. But that's who she talking about. But exactly, that's what I'm saying. Ebro the rapper. Ain't no Ebro the rapper. But that's who she talking about. But exactly, that's what I'm saying. Rolling to the purposes. Tell my Ebro the producer. Yeah, Ebro. Oh man, should we get one more for the fishbowl? Uh, the last topic before we wrap it up, let's see what's going on. I've had fun with you guys. Can I just say I appreciate y'all coming here. Oh, this is a good one right here. Uh, I appreciate y'all. This was dope and we got to have y'all back again at some point. Um, because I just enjoyed y'all. This was dope. I'm glad, like, fool, I'm glad to get, like, I've been talking to fool about this podcast. We ran into each other randomly, like, about, shoot, it's almost been a month ago.
I thought it was like two, 3
It was around Super Bowl. That's all all been a month ago. It's we at the end of February. He was like, man, I seen the podcast. I like what y'all doing. I want to get up. I'm like, who I fuck with you?
Come through.
Come through. Yeah. But like schedules and whatever. So this
and
like.
You know, you ain't got no fan service.
I mean, you caught us on it. This is not, we don't. Tony, tell him how we do it.
Normally, Mike got some stuff.
We usually be doing it. That's why we want
to have a snack.
No, because we be having snacks. We be having libations. We have some chips and shit too. Don't play us like that. Okay. We going to bring you back. We going to work something out because we want you to come back too. All right. But our last topic of the podcast, who or what was your favorite hip hop collabo? Your favorite. We've touched on this before. We never fully discussed it, but like we had Dana Dane on the podcast before. We've had Dwayne The Rock on the podcast before. He's produced for Raekwon, KRS-One, Big Daddy Kane, a number of people. And so Mary J. Blige, Method Man, You're All I Need, constantly comes up in conversation. I think that's a dope hip hop collabo. I don't know if even that's my favorite. I gotta think about it, but you know. It's a good ass question. It's a great question to end on the podcast.
Okay, I'm gonna give you something I'd probably eat.
Okay.
I'm gonna go with I got three.
Okay. All right.
Outkast and Slick Rick.
Okay. The artist storyteller.
You gonna respect me.
Yeah. Slick Rick blended in that track.
Y'all gonna quit acting like Tony gonna put y'all on parole.
Nah, I respect this shit, you know what I mean?
Cause he know what he's talking about.
Method and Red.
Yes.
Okay.
Yep. Yes. Yep. Which Method Red though? The whole album, the
Blackout
album. Okay, amen.
And
when them two got together, I love
Fabulous and any R&B star out. Nigga, Fab is good on any R&B shit. He's the greatest dude for you. You want to rap on your hook or
put Fab on?
Put Fab.
Was he on I'm So Into You with Tamia?
Probably.
Okay, I like that one. I like Breathe. That's still one of my favorites.
Breathe is dope. Breathe is dope.
It was cute.
Uh-huh.
It was cute. He got way better.
Tony, you got something?
Jonnae,
you got something?
Oh, I got something.
Okay, what's yours?
Oh, I got I'm gonna just go easy. I'm gonna go Nas and AZ. Nice and bitch.
Yeah, that was good.
Nice and bitch. And I'm gonna throw in Nas and Pops on the horn. So
yeah, that was my favorite. The Olu Dollar.
Woo!
Oh, man. Horn. Just give me. Huh? You remember that? On AZ, I'm gonna give me what you
want. Yeah, man, come on, man.
Let's go.
I'm gonna go with the Get By remix with Talib Kweli, okay. Kanye, Mos Def, Jay, and Busta Rhymes.
I remember that joint.
And I like, first of all, it was already a dope little song, and then it's like, oh, okay, Jay and Mos Def and Talib all on the song. Jay-Z and Kanye on the Get By remix. But then I didn't see Busta coming, and when he came, I was like, oh, they got Busta on this too. Like that shit, like went 4 or 5 minutes. That shit was tight.
I remember that joint.
So that was one.
How you said? ODB and Busta Rhymes.
Oh.
Yeah. Yo, what about Tribe and Leaders of the New School for the Scenario? That was
the Scenario was awesome. It's still a classic song. Here We Go, Yo. That shit was crazy. I Got You All in Check remix. Is that what you're talking about with ODB?
No, he was a. You talking about Get Your Money? What album was that on? That
know.
Beat was so
it
crazy.
Was crazy.
Oh, I'm gonna go with Guantanamera. I'm sorry. I'm gonna go with that.
You don't get your Guantanamera.
I'm gonna go with that. Here's why. First of all, Wyclef took a classic salsa song. He has a historical legend, Celia Cruz on the track. The way he flipped the beat was cold. And then to have Lauren rhyme on that shit, like this historic shit
the
was
Carnival
not going
was a
down.
Hard album,
the Carnival was a good
she
album.
She came and was like, nah. Yeah. Like that shit was crazy.
Just because you give it this,
That shit was crazy. He said Guantanamera was hot garbage. That was hot.
That song was hot garbage. The Carnival was a good album. That shit she talking, that shit's for the birds.
No, it's not. That was not hot garbage. I'm gonna tell you another one that was dope to me.
Don't say to you.
Shut the fuck up. Bone Thugs in Harmony, okay, Biggie Smalls.
I'm gonna let y'all know right now.
But Biggie and Bone, that shit was smooth.
I didn't fuck with All Eyes on Me.
All Eyes. And you know what? While we talking collabos, one of my favorite collabos was My Mind Made Up. Come on, get into Method Man, Red Man, Tupac.
I remember that track.
Do you know
that shit was cool?
You know, Bone is the only artist to perform with a song. Tupac and Biggie.
Yep. Cause I was heavy on that Bone Thug life.
Bone Thug.
He's 99 Eternal was my shit.
I'm proud of.
Jonnae, what's yours?
I know this is corny, but I don't know why it's standing out. Touch it, bring it, swing it, bang it, mean it,
fuck it. On the remix we had.
I don't know what it was, but that song was called
Busta Rhymes. That shit was crazy. Calm down, Bust. Turn it up. That shit was crazy.
Maybe
I could crunch.
Busta, when he hit his element, he's damn near.
You know, I like the song before it became like a song for dancers. Certain people get the song, I'm like, I'm done with it. Y'all niggas fucked with that.
I like the OG.
It was cute at the
Fantasy, that's classic. ODB, Mariah, he thumped it out.
For her to be so, you know, glam or whatever that was at the time.
It worked together.
It worked.
But you know what? All her collabos worked. That was really the genius of it.
Right here, she good at collabos.
She really was. She was on her own for a minute.
She does. I was surprised.
Everybody was because she had credibility. When Dame Dash can't even go, oh, Mariah's the homie. Mariah can gully. He was like, yo, Mariah can get gully.
Yep.
So it's like, you know.
I remember Christina Aguilera had Red Man on the track.
Dirty.
It worked.
So are all hearts and minds clear?
Yeah.
Guys. The mic picks up everything, guys.
It's cool. School, that's what make it grind. It's hip hop, nigga.
This podcast costs $20.
That's what I'm talking about. This ain't no boo, nigga. Somebody hear the neighbors next time.
Actually, we're at the clothing store. Shout out to Rostin Clothing for letting us house the podcast here today.
5882 Pico.
Yeah. Shout out that address one more time.
582 West Pico Boulevard. Cross Street Fairfax.
Hey, man, you better get him down. Shout out to Ross State Clothing. Right. And the owner of TB. His name is TB, Tony Baker. That's
Tony Baker, we out here.
Yeah. So, thank you for housing us today, because this is not our normal shoot day. But if all hearts and minds are clear, everybody...
You the first to do a pop-up shop.
Pop-up shop podcast. Yeah, we originated.
Pop-up shop podcast.
I like that.
Listen, could you be our marketing fool? That was hot.
I like that.
You should do Dante's show next.
We should. Yo, okay, so check.
Oh, yeah?
No, we should. We're going to set that up after the podcast. But everybody shout out your social media, and we're going to tell everybody bye.
Okay.
Boom.
My social media is My Bad Fool, just how you spell it, M-Y. I'm not spelling it right. B-A-D-F-U. My Bad Fool.
On everything. He's on Twitter and IG.
Oh, if you want to go to Facebook, my original name, FuQuan Johnson.
The government.
Yeah. That you scouting people.
But I mean, let me say it, not you.
Okay, amen, praise it.
All right, here we go. Instagram, Jonnae the Queen, J-O-N-N-A-E, the Queen. For Facebook, Twitter, Jonnae Thompson, J-O-N-N-A-E-T-H-O-M-P-S-O-N.
Pow. Tony Baker.
At Tony Baker Comedy on everything except Facebook. Facebook is comedian Tony Baker.
You better get on down. And I'm at Aarona Lopez, at Aarona Lopez 100 on IG. That's the only account that matters to me. So follow me on there. I had a Dominican husband. Look, I'm Aarona Lopez on Facebook as well. Make sure y'all follow the podcast at @hiphop_raised_us on IG. That's @hiphop_raised_us on IG. Follow it and make sure y'all catch us every Tuesday. We drop new episodes every Tuesday on SoundCloud and iTunes. Follow us, like it, share it, subscribe. It's free. Get on down.
And yeah, I will slide you my number in the DM if you want to holler at the guy.
Holler at the guy, FuQuan. We out.